Good Sunday morning to everyone. This is Ryan with the National Weather Service in Norman with a severe weather update for Sunday, April 13th. This briefing was created around 6 a.m. this morning. So, what's expected today through Tuesday morning? Well, first and foremost, severe thunderstorms appear likely today. The most favorable area for severe thunderstorms is going to exist mainly along and east of I-35 this afternoon through this evening. The main threats are going to be damaging winds and large hail, although there will be a brief tornado threat east of I-35 and south of I-40. The threat is not that high, but we'll discuss the potential here in a little while, so you want to keep that in mind. In addition to severe storms, critical fire weather conditions will be present this afternoon and early this evening across portions of southwestern Oklahoma and western North Texas. This is where breezy southwest winds will combine with the very dry and hot conditions. And then it's going to be much colder behind the front tonight all the way through Monday. And then freezing temperatures are expected by Tuesday morning. Before we look at the severe weather threat, I wanted to briefly take a look at the red flag warning that's in effect today from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. across southwestern Oklahoma and western North Texas. This is where conditions will be most favorable for rapid fire spread. So if you're out working today, don't drive over tall grass. Don't do any welding outside. Anything that can cause a spark, you don't want to mess with any of that. Don't burn any trash, obviously. And please don't throw your cigarettes out the windows, okay? Because any fires that do happen to develop will have the potential to spread very rapidly. Okay, so here's what the severe weather threat looks like for this afternoon and this evening across portions of Oklahoma and just a sliver of western North Texas, at least in our forecast area. And the yellow shaded area is where we see some severe storms are going to be possible. And the orange shaded area, that's a greater potential. There may be some higher coverage out there. In other words, more storms will be across that area. Timing of this, mainly around 3 p.m. to midnight. Initially, storms may develop across northern Oklahoma, and then as the cold front dives south through the evening hours into central and southeastern Oklahoma, the main threats are going to be damaging winds and large hail up to at least the size of golf balls. And as I mentioned before, there is a tornado threat mainly across southeastern and southern Oklahoma near the Red River. So here's what the tornado potential looks like for this evening, mainly from about 5 to 9 p.m. across southern and southeastern Oklahoma. The key word to remember here is potential. Just because you're in the shaded areas doesn't mean there's going to be even a single tornado. But this is where the most favorable environment is going to develop during this time. This is also going to be a favorable environment for damaging winds over 70 miles per hour. And remember, those can be just as destructive as weak tornadoes. So the greatest potential for tornadoes is going to exist from about Ada to Durant and then eastward into Atoka County. If you do end up under a severe thunderstorm warning this afternoon or this evening, get indoors, obviously, and get away from the windows, all right? So in addition to the severe winds, you could have hail falling. Hail could break out the window. I've seen it happen before. Someone been injured by hail busting through a window. So if it's a severe thunderstorm warning, get indoors. Obviously, if it's a tornado warning, get indoors quickly. Put as many walls between you and the outside as possible. Get into an interior closet or such. Cover up. Protect your head. If you have helmets, wear those. Also, the most important thing to do this morning, if you don't have a plan in place already, get one in place. Discuss it with your family. All right? Also, let your friends and family know about the severe weather threat today if they don't tend to pay attention to the weather very much, which doesn't happen very often in Oklahoma. But go ahead, if you know someone in southern Oklahoma or southeastern Oklahoma, if they don't know about the threat today, give them a ring and let them know about the severe potential, especially near sunset this evening. All right, this image shows the timing of the severe weather from about 3 to 7 p.m. You can see the cold front arriving around 4 p.m. just west of the I-44 corridor. And the greatest threat for the thunderstorms is going to be from near Ponca City to the northeast sides of the Oklahoma City metro. Also notice the dry line pushing through southwestern Oklahoma and western North Texas. And behind this is where the fire weather threat I mentioned earlier is going to be. Moving closer towards sunset tonight from about 7 p.m. to midnight, this is what the severe storm timing looks like. It doesn't mean it's not going to rain anywhere else. This is just the timing for the severe storms. We see that the storms will move southward with the cold front, and that cold front is positioned... The cold front is around 9 p.m. This is the timing of the cold front. So the higher severe chances will move closer to the Red River by this time. All right, well, that wraps up the severe threat for today and tonight. So let's talk a little bit about Monday behind the front. 40s, 50s. Well, that's just pretty cold for this time of year. Add a 15 to 30 mile per hour wind, and you end up with wind chills in the 20s and 30s. So it's just going to be downright cold on Monday. Try not to complain too much. I know I won't. But I guess we could all just have a case of the Mondays. Finally, by Tuesday morning, skies will clear, the winds will lighten, very dry air will be in place, so temperatures will drop. In fact, they will drop below freezing for much of the area, so we have a freeze watch that's in effect for Tuesday morning. And this will likely become a freeze warning and could even extend across the Red River into Texas. So be sure to protect any tender vegetation that you might have out. And if you have sensitive pets, small pets especially, go ahead and bring them indoors as well for Tuesday morning, since it'll be kind of a shock for everyone there. That concludes the briefing for this morning. I hope everyone stays safe today and tonight. And please remember, have a plan in place. If you don't have one in place right now, then go ahead and take the time to take 10 minutes out of your day this morning, gather your family or your friends, and discuss what you would do during a tornado warning or a severe thunderstorm warning. You can follow us on Twitter at NWS Norman. Like us on Facebook if you haven't done that already. And then obviously, you know, we're on YouTube if you're watching this. And for the latest graphics or information, forecast, check our webpage at weather.gov/Norman. Thanks for watching and enjoy your new work week.